Gloria Gaynor, I Will Survive, number one on the singles chart this week in 1979. More 70s music in the next hour and a chat with the irrepressible and wonderful Captain Sensible. This is Radio 2 on the BBC Sound app, on your smart speaker and on 88 to 91 FM.
BBC News at 4 o'clock. This is Nick Qureshi. Welsh rugby union clubs have voted to make big changes to the way the sport is run. They held a special meeting to address claims made in an investigation by BBC Wales. Nellie Bird sent this report from outside the meeting in Port Talbots.
It's been a difficult couple of months for the WRU following a scandal highlighting allegations of misogyny, racism and a toxic working environment. And so clubs were being asked to vote on big changes to the WRU's board, bringing in more independent voices and women. In the end, it was a fairly short and straightforward meeting, the mood upbeat, and the special resolution passed by a big majority. 245 of the 252 clubs who registered voted in favour. The WRU now aims to have the changes in place by the end of the year.
The government says it will make possession of nitrous oxide or laughing gas an offence. The ban is part of plans for a wider crackdown on antisocial behaviour. The Levelling Up Secretary, Michael Gove, said using the gas as a psychoactive substance fuelled other problems. It's been revealed the number of strip searches of children being carried out under police stop and search powers in England and Wales reached 3,000 between 2018 and last year. The Children's Commissioner, Dame Rachel D'Souza, found around half of searches were conducted without an appropriate adult. The National Police Chiefs Council said it would carefully consider her report. A former boss of John Lewis has said dismantling its staff-owned structure would be a tragedy. Reports last week suggested the partnership's chair, Dame Sharon White, was exploring plans to sell a stake to an outside investor to raise cash, ending its current model after more than 100 years. Speaking on Sunday with Laura Koonsberg, Andy Street, now the Conservative Mayor of the West Midlands, said if that happened, John Lewis would lose its ethos.
John Lewis goes a bit beyond a shop. You know, you can buy the same television in other places, is the truth. But John Lewis was about actually a way of doing business, actually showing the market there was a better way almost. And in fact, that's now potentially, if you believe what it says in the press, under threat. So I would urge the leadership of John Lewis to think about what's really at the heart of it, what makes it special, and hold on to that.
Now, if you've had trouble getting used to the clocks going forward an hour today, spare a thought for people in Lebanon who've woken up in two rival time zones. It's because of a row among political and religious authorities, as Catherine Cracknell explains.
Clocks in Lebanon would normally have gone forward on the last Sunday in March, but last week the country's Muslim caretaker Prime Minister, Najib Mikati, announced that wouldn't now happen until the 20th of April, after Ramadan. Christian authorities, though, are ploughing ahead with the clock change. Mr. Mikati hasn't given a reason for the decision, but commentators say allowing Muslims to break their fast an hour earlier could boost his popularity. The decision has caused confusion. Mobile phones and other electronic devices automatically switched because they didn't have enough notice.
And that's the BBC News at 4:03. Travel now, here's Orna.
Nick, thank you very much. First of all, the M56, so this is in Cheshire, it's travelling east from the end at Junction 15. That's where it meets the M53 through to Chester Services at Junction 14. So a vehicle caught fire. One of the lanes has been closed to recover the vehicle. Apparently the fire is out, but the queues are still there. And the Liverpool end of the M62, long delays on the eastbound side from the Rocket at Junction 4, the end of the motorway, through to Highton, that's at Junction 5, and on to Junction 6 at Tarbuck Island. Now that's where it meets the M57. We've got road works along that stretch. I think there's a lane closure in place as well, which is why it's so heavy. Glasgow queues are on the M8 on the eastbound side from 20 at the Kingston Bridge through to 17 at Great Western Road. The M6 still looking a little bit slow down towards the M55 on the southbound side approaching Junction 32. And Gloucestershire, the M5 southbound Cribbs Causeway at 17. There was a breakdown that was in one of the lanes. It shouldn't be too long. It should go soon, heading towards the M49 at Junction 18. The A12, there's been an accident in Essex. It's at Junction 27. Is at the Avenue of Remembrance roundabout, and so slow traffic there. Then the closure in over the weekend, southbound 16 to 12. Gallywood to Mount Nessing, it's a long closure, that one, causing delays on the approach as well. It's the southbound side, and severe delays in London. It's the west side, really. The M4 is closed from 2 at Brentford through to where it meets the A4, where it becomes it there. Back with more in an hour.